Looking squares with lines and dots. They are called QR codes, which stands for quick response. When you scan it with your phone, the unique pattern translates into human readable data. While you think it's just a restaurant menu or maybe a website, it can actually lead you to some problems. Huh? Scott Schaefer is the lead security officer at Blade Technologies, Inc. to give us some insight. Now, I'm looking at this. When I first saw them, I had no idea what it was.
Sure.
Didn't know what to do with it. But you say these have been around for 25 years?
They've been around a long time. They've gained a lot of popularity recently, especially with all the contactless stuff we were trying to do during the pandemic.
Right.
And in fact, in China, they use these everywhere. And, you know, they keep such a close look of their population that when you walk into a building, you scan the code. When you go into a room,
wow.
You scan. That's how they keep track, and they can really lock these cities down and such.
I know during the Super Bowl they put one on in one of the commercials for 30 seconds and people just ran to their TV and said, I gotta scan it.
Yeah.
Nobody knew what it was till they did it.
Yeah.
That can be dangerous.
It could be. You gotta be careful, but just like anything else. You know, you can scan it, it'll come up, and what will happen in most operating systems on your phones, it'll come up and say, okay, I'm gonna send you to this URL or I'm gonna open this app or something like that.
Uh-huh.
So just check that URL. We're gonna demo here in a second.
It was so popular it crashed the website.
Yeah.
That Super Bowl. All right, what are you going to show us?
Okay, let me show you.
You got this neat setup.
Yeah. Well, you have a QR code there.
Right here, yeah.
And what we're going to do is I've got displaying my phone up here. I've got an Android phone, so for me, I just go here to scan QR code.
Okay.
And then hold that up, and I'm going to scan it from here.
Alrighty.
And you'll see it grabs it, scans it, and then it says, okay, here's the web address. Fox 2 Now author KTVI Naughton. So
I'm
going to open that in the browser, and there you are. So that's what it's really for.
How about that?
Yeah. So that's what a good use of it is, because you can put it on a business card, things like
that. This is not a scam, by the way. This is legit.
Yeah, exactly. So, and that's the trick. When it scans it, it's going to tell you, okay, we're going to do this now. Right? And you got to make sure that it's not sending you somewhere weird, doesn't make sense, because you can always exit out.
Some of the notes you sent me said, you know, don't scan the ones that you just see on a telephone
on
pole
a
or something like that. Right.
Right. Yeah, you have to be careful with that. Those, if you're just seeing one randomly somewhere, it's okay to scan it. It's not going to hurt you. But if you do what the code tells you to do, could potentially hurt you, like send you to a website, open an app, these things.
It's the same stuff you've been telling us for years. It'll take you to a website, and we just click away willy-nilly sometimes, thinking like, oh, this has to be legit, but they can get into your info.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, and that's the part of it. When the bad guys use these codes, it's for really one reason only. It's for theft. They want to steal your credentials, anything like that, so they can make some money. So that's one thing. But we're seeing it more and more in restaurants.
Yeah.
Now you walk in, you scan it. And I really like the idea of restaurants using this, because I hate going to a restaurant and going over the menu and debating and then deciding on a dish and then come to find out when the server comes, they're out.
They're out of it.
So what they could do with this type of menu is they could, when they run out of that dish, they could just remove it. It would update in real time.
Easily.
So somebody would scan it and they wouldn't see that dish.
The wave of the future. Who knew?
It's cool
stuff. Been around for a quarter of a century. I had no idea. Great stuff. Thank you for the demo. That's awesome. If you have any technical kind of issues or questions, Scott's your guy. We will link you up to Blade Technologies, Inc. on our website, as well as our Fox 2 mobile app. John, that was cool, wasn't it?
Scott always has
always
the best ideas. Thank you for coming in and sharing.